Hello everyone, my name is Andre and today we are back with some more Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged, this time episode 12, Duel of the Dead. Such a threatening name, you know? This actually doesn't seem like a parody of anything. Maybe, you know, Dawn of the Dead, Shaun of the Dead. I guess they work, but this actually seems like the type of episode name that the show would utilize. It seems like legit. Unlike the others who seem like parodies, this one seems kind of legit. But I like it still. It's a cool name, so hopefully we'll see how that ties in. But yeah, that's about it. Let's begin, shall we? This is also the last pre-recorded episode. So after this one, maybe stuff is going to change, I don't know. It will depend on your feedback. As always, feedback helps a lot the channel, so... you know, you guys will probably write comments explaining stuff to me and giving me more knowledge on Yu-Gi-Oh! So possibly the future episodes, you'll have a more intelligent and more knowledgeable Andre. That's right. You thought that would be impossible, making me smarter, but you are wrong. You are wrong. I can be smarter. I promise. I can be smarter. I can. Regardless, as always, guys, please don't forget to show your support. Little Kuriboh links are in the description below. And as always, if you enjoy the content and want to help out the channel, please do not forget to subscribe. It really helps a lot and helps the channel grow and helps the channel continue its independence fight. So if you don't mind, please do help out. It really means a lot. And join my wonderful community. The guys... in this community, the guys that have subscribed have all been great guys, great dudes, you know. They always do their best to try to help me out, and they're just the greatest. I'm really proud of the small community that I have right now, which I say small, but it's actually huge, like 120 something people as of the time of this recording. That's huge. That's huge. So I really appreciate everyone who subscribed already, and I really appreciate every single one of you. Like, it means the world. It really does. And hopefully, you know, hopefully we continue getting more people and attracting more people to the channel. That would be a dream come true. So thank you so much for watching up until now, and let's continue, shall we?
No duel monsters were harmed during the making of this episode.
Bullshit.
Except for Kuriboh.
Help, I'm being chased by the slowest dragon in the universe. Think of all the card games I'll never play. Oh no, it's Kuribohzilla. I knew he'd come to me one day. If you think this is huge, then you...
Good shot. Like this one and the previous one. Let's see if we can see it. No, but the other one, the other one, I've talked about this in the Android 17 against that old man guy, but these kinds of shots just make the person look way more intimidating than they should. Again, shadows always work in favor, and this is a very good way to show how shadows can improve, like, facial expressions, because if you take away the shadows, if you occupy this dark spots here with the skin tone, he wouldn't look as terrifying as he is right now, not even near as much. Like, he probably would look like just like a normal dude, just like, you know. it wouldn't be much different, but this mixed with the angle of the scene, right, works beautifully to make him look so much more intimidating and huge.
You should see my ego. Now sit at your master's feet like the dog that you are. But I don't want to be a furry. Shut up and bend over. Yes, master.
Oh. Oh my.
Nyeh. What a nightmare. That was almost as bad as that dream I had where Kuriboh beat me in a card game. Actually, Joey, I think that really happened. It was a dream.
It hey, was Yugi, a dream.
My Skankentine told me to give you this letter. How the hell am I supposed to read this? It's just a bunch of pink smudges.
Yugi's got a girlfriend.
That does it. Tristan is so getting a mind crush.
Poor Tristan. Is he that useless in the show? Because, you know, I get it, you know, Thea is the girl, Joey is the best friend, so, Bakura is the kinda evil, kinda not guy, you know, so, what's Tristan, I guess, he's just the jock, But Joey technically is also a very sportsy guy, isn't he? So I guess Tristan does not have a role. Fair enough. Poor guy. He's the Yamcha of Yu-Gi-Oh. Let's see if he brings towels.
I've been working on my dance moves. I call this one the Joey. Joey, that's the worst dance I've ever seen. You're just jealous. Brains.
You said it, zombie boy.
Boy, isn't that Yugi? The only person on the island whose hair is more ridiculous than ours. Brains. Let's go do more cliche henchman things.
Okay.
Excellent work, my fellow Americans. It sounds like those kids are about to fall right into my trap. God. In America. Oi, boss, you know we're not actually in America, right? I don't understand a word you just said. Try speaking American. It's the only language I understand.
I gotta go take a whiff.
I'm not going to do any comments on that. I'm not. Good joke. It's a good
joke.
Too
much information, Joey.
That's all I'll say.
Graveyard arena should be around here somewhere. These sunglasses sure make it difficult to see in the dark, but I refuse to take them off because I'm an American, and Americans always wear sunglasses.
He's such a stereotype. My favorite Shakespeare amazing. Quote.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him. In America.
Ain't nothing like getting out what you gotta get out. Hello, did you enjoy watching me pee?
Rise and shine, dweeb.
Hey, where the heck are we?
Brains.
Oh no, it's a goth. I wonder what's keeping Joey. If he's gone much longer, we'll have to give his screen time to Bakura. Let's ditch the tosser. Score a wallet. Finders keepers.
Hey, that's Joey's fine-ass sister. I'd recognize that come-hither look anywhere.
Let's all wander...
Oof.
Blindly into that cave over there. What do you people want from
that,
me?
You're that made me feel dirty. That line made me feel dirty. I need a shower after this.
Star chips, dweeb. I have a score to settle with Pegasus. So Zombie Boy here is gonna beat you in a card game.
Why didn't you just take my star chips when I was unconscious?
Shut the hell up. It's time for Zombie Boy to sing the American National Anthem. In America. Brains, 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 brains.
He has the voice of a zombie angel.
We can't find Joey anywhere. This is so totally the opposite of super special awesome. Whatever that is.
Look, a couple of coffins. These'll come in handy when we kill Joey for making us look for him.
Oh, wait, supermodel. Stop trying to make out with Taya. That's...
These jokes make me laugh, but these ones are not that great. I'll say that. They make me laugh because it's easy to make me laugh. I do like it. It just tickles my sense of humor, but they are not that great. I'll say that. Like, a supermodel, sure, it's because it's skinny that you can see the bones. Like, it's an easy joke, and it's like, meh. But I find it funny, personally. I find it funny, but it's not that great humor, in my opinion. Well, that's fine.
My job. Yugi touched me. That means we're engaged. Hey, what happened to Bakura? Maybe they finally ran out of the show.
Help! This supermodel's one of my fangirls. Not a fangirl. Come back here and help me, you wankers.
Who's smexy now, bitch?
We should be okay as long as you guys don't trigger any more obvious traps.
Oh, smeg.
Is everyone from England a total spaz, Bakura?
Pretty much.
What the fuck is... Damn. Like Indiana Jones bullshit.
Gangway! Women and she-males first! Oh!
I liked that one. Again, it's kind of a weak joke, but I liked it.
Oh, bollocks! It got Bakura!
Good! I shall avenge his death! My voice gives me super strength! Holy shit, it really does!
Oh, it was just a balloon with a speaker inside. I guess I wet my pants for nothing.
Somebody tell my fangirls
I love them. Looks like Bakura's scarred for life again.
I sure wish Yugi were here. How am I supposed to prove my independence without his help?
Don't worry, Joey, we're here to rescue you. Wait a second, have you been playing a card game? We were worried sick about you.
Hey, I'm trying to regain my self-esteem here.
You hang out with us. You don't have any self-esteem.
Of course.
Oh, yeah. Seems you're out of luck, dweeb. Zombie Boy's monsters are about to wipe out your life points.
Let me guess. In America, right?
I wasn't gonna say that.
But yes. In America.
Joey, you can still win. Just remember your love for Serenity and you can do anything. You're right, Yug. That was my favorite Joss Whedon movie. This is the canceling Firefly, you goth bastard.
Brains.
Well, Joey, it looks like you learned an important lesson. The only way to kill a zombie is to destroy the brain.
I also learned that I'm secretly a furry.
Once again, too much information, Joey.
Yeah.
Let's get out of here before we get eaten by a group.
They'll never be able to get past this cardboard cutout of a boulder. Another victory for America.
Good.
It's no use. It's made of solid cardboard. I can't believe...
That's good. That's good. That's a great joke.
I'm trapped in a cave with four guys.
Fancy a shag, Taya?
Oops. I mean three guys.
I'm bringing Smexy by.
Get out of my head! Get out of my head!
That was a good episode. I will say, some of the comedy was a bit weaker. Now, even though it made me laugh, I did find that comedy to be a bit weaker. Like, stuff like the jokes on Bakura. Like, they're kind of easy to do, right? Because, you know, Bakura looks like a girl. Girl jokes, you know. It seems like he went for the easier jokes. Not to say that they aren't, like, kind of clever. I like the way he did the jokes. And I guess that's why it made me laugh. But the jokes were kind of easy. And I found that the comedy on this one was not as on point as maybe in other episodes. I don't know. It felt a bit weaker comedy-wise on this one. Maybe it's because the other episodes focuses itself more on criticizing the show, whilst this one was on making fun of the characters and the stereotypes and stuff like that. I don't know, but it did felt that way to me. I like how in the end he criticized the fact that that boulder in no way, shape, or form looked like it was three-dimensional. Like, it looked like just like a cardboard cutout. Jesus Christ. But yeah, I really enjoy that. But yeah, that's the episode. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. If you did, please don't forget to drop a like, subscribe, share it with your friends. Follow me on social media, all that good stuff. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye!